Gengar Gang. What is going on? My name is Ryan. This is the Analytic Gengar, and welcome to another video. In today's video, friends, I'm finally doing that box break from, like, I don't know how many months ago. And this is the Chilling Rain box that we will open. Just a little bit of background for you, for anyone who is new or not up to date or is new to the channel, welcome. This was part of a giveaway that I did celebrating 1,000 subscribers, and so you were able to join the giveaway by liking a post, and four random people were selected to win 9 packs of Chilling Rain out of this booster box that I will be breaking today. Now, a couple of things before we go ahead and get started. In addition to the booster box, which you can still see on screen right here, I do have all these packs, so in order to make sure my watch time metrics are padded, we will be opening those up as well, hoping to pull another alternate art or at least something good for my binder. In addition to that, the way that box breaks work here on this channel and pretty much across the entire community is we will go ahead and open the packs, we will go ahead and place them in a baggie. I'm just using regular hefty bags because 9 packs is a little bit on the bigger slash thicker side. And then the one thing is that each will be security sealed. So you can see right here, I have security seals. These are total transfer, as you can see right here. And what that means is that they completely remove themselves once they are tampered. So this will be your way of making sure that when you receive your giveaway items, they have not been tampered with. And as you can see, I'll go ahead and get those put on and documented very clearly for everyone who has won a giveaway. So without further ado, and the rules fully established, let's go ahead and get started by taking a look at all of the different individuals who went ahead and won. First up is going to be Jonathan W. So Jonathan W, congrats on winning part of the giveaway. Let's go ahead and get this box open, and then the first 9 packs will go to Jonathan. Of course, every booster box that's opened, we go ahead and we shuffle all of the packs so that there's no, you know, box mapping gimmick. And then, yeah, that's how that goes. And then, more importantly, everything, I will do my absolute best to make sure that it stays on screen the entire time. So there are all of the packs. Let's go ahead and get rid of this over here. And then let's just start mixing these up really randomly. Yeah, there you go. That'll work. And then on top of that, what I will do is I will go ahead and actually just randomly select. So on top of that, there is a level of randomness to all of this as well. So there are all of our packs. Jonathan W, you're up first. So let's try to get a art set at least. So there's another random one. So there's an art set for Jonathan W. And then we'll do 2, 1, and 1. That is going to be a total of 9 packs. There you go. As you can see, still on screen. And then I'll go ahead and get them loaded into a baggie for you. And there you have it. So now let's go ahead and get that sealed. And this is also very good in case no one knows what a box break is or how it works. I'll go ahead and seal this, and then the next thing that I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna leave those right there for half a second. I am going to go ahead and grab one of these security seals off screen. So here is the security seal. This one is 9-4, as you can see on screen right there. And then we're just gonna literally go ahead and security seal this all the way across. So there you have it, Jonathan W. You should be expecting these in the mail. And please do let us know if you pull anything good out of them. Next up is the unclaimed packs. So this is weird. One of the giveaway winners actually never claimed their packs. So what I had said was, I am hoping that I can go ahead and actually have those packs used for a giveaway in the future. So there you have it, a full art set. And then we'll just grab 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's go ahead and make sure that we have a total of 9 packs. Awesome. I'll go ahead and leave them right there on screen. go ahead and get another hefty bag opened. And then get these slid in there really nicely. There you go. And then we'll go ahead and seal that up across. We'll go ahead and just puff those slightly up. There you go. And then finally but not least, I'll put that on screen again while I go ahead and grab a security seal. So what's the deal with these? Well, don't know yet. You know, it's 9 chilling rain packs. Anyone who ever wins them can always come back here and reference this video. As you can see, that's gonna be 595. And yeah, so there's, you know, 9 that someone will win sometime in the future. Now, as for the rest of the packs on screen, they belong to 2 different people. Now, I do have to shout out Let's Open Some Packs because he is the person who came up with the idea. I think it's awesome that they did. And I'm really glad that they suggested it because it actually is probably going to be a really cool thing once we go ahead and get this started. Let's Open Up Some Packs decided to say that we should probably go ahead and donate his packs. So we are actually going to be donating his 9 packs, and instead of mailing them off to him, we'll just mail them off to a separate charity, which I think is just really a good idea. Obviously, tons of people have or need this kind of stuff because, you know, they're unfortunately not able to enjoy the hobby as much as we do, and that's totally fine. So I think that helping out those in need is awesome, and again, big shout out to Let's Open Some Packs for suggesting it because I think it was a great idea. Now, he is going to have his packs sent off to Commons for Kids, and this is a charity that specializes in trading cards. Both Let's Open Some Packs and myself have looked into it, and so we, you know, reasonably think this is a totally legitimate charity and a really cool thing to do. So 9 packs, and again, I will try to go ahead and get a art set up perfect, and then just 1, 1, 1, and 1, and then let's go ahead and count those, and that's going to be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. So these 9 packs, let's go ahead and put those over there, will be going there. And then you have these packs right over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. These packs belong to our friend Jaden Chen, who also opted to have his packs sent off to the Commons for Kids charity. So far we have 18 packs of cards going off to Commons for Charity, or Commons for Kids rather. Now, in addition to that, what I'm going to go ahead and do is add on 1 entire booster box, 36 packs sealed, going off to Commons for Kids. And as part of the spirit of giving, I wanted to open up this offer to the rest of the community. So here is how you can help if you'd like to send something off to Commons for Kids. 1, I will leave all of their contact information down below. So if you'd like to just simply send something off on your own behalf without any issues, please go ahead and feel free to do so. Additionally, if you want to go ahead and have something shipped off from me, I have a few different options available to you. The first is that you can get in touch and DM or email me and let me know and send something to my PO box. So if you don't want to send it off, you can send it off to me, send it to my PO box, let me know what it's for, and I will go ahead and clearly document the process of me receiving the package and then go ahead and make sure that it gets to Commons for Kids safely and securely. The other thing that you can do is that if you don't want to pay the shipping, but you still want to donate something to them, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have another entire set of battle styles as well as Chilling Rain packs available. All of those packs will come from booster boxes, and if needed, I can go ahead and show me opening and packaging up all this stuff, either on a live stream or on a video that I record and then just upload with no sort of editing work done to it. Now, if you want to do that, I am going to charge a literally distributor pricing for this. So I am taking a loss on it, but enabling other folks in the community to donate something to kids in need. So you'll pay, give or take, $3.30 a pack, and you can pick Battle Styles or Chilling Rain, and we'll go ahead and get all of that stuff sent off. This way, all you do is pay under MSRP for booster packs. You know that they're going to a good charity, and this way you also save on shipping. So those are the two options you have for you. If you'd like, you can send something straight to them. If you'd like, you could send something to me that I will send on your behalf as part of the larger package. And if you want, you can buy booster packs from me at below MSRP. I will be making no money off of it, and we will make sure that all of those packs go to kids in need and kids who can really use this stuff and take part in this amazing hobby as well. So those are the rest of the 18 packs that are sitting in the back right there. And just to make sure that we don't get them confused, I'm going to go ahead and shift them off screen right now. So again, if anybody is interested in taking part in this little charitable thing we got going, please feel free to let me know. If you guys want to share this video with friends and get them involved as well, I am more than happy to do so. And just so everyone knows, I have cases of Battle Styles and Chilling Rain downstairs in storage, so there is absolutely no question I'll be able to send off as little or as much as this community is willing to give. And again, no profit being made on my side. I'm literally taking a loss on this stuff because of the way prices are right now. But I want to make sure that that option is available to you all, and I want to make sure that you all know that there's more than one way that you can give back. So, with all that said, congratulations again to all of the giveaway winners. Ironically enough, there was literally only one that's getting shipped out, but that's fine. The other two are going to obviously get packaged up as part of a larger giveaway, and expect to see those packs again. I won't security seal them because I don't know if they're going to take kindly to that. I feel like they're just going to want random packs, but at least they're a sealed product, which is good. And then here, for your viewing entertainment, is I think 16 packs from ETBs, so let's see what we do here. Now, to start wrapping up this video, I guess, as I can't open this one pack, the one thing I will say is that, yeah, it's been pretty rough with this, so there's a Gardevoir. There's a code card for you, if you like it. Wonderful. So Chilling Rain's been a rough set. Now, I did do an analysis video a couple weeks ago now at this point, where I basically showed you, like, hey, here's what I'm doing. Here's, oh, a white code card. That's nice. Let's see. Oh, good. Two hollows and two packs. Lovely. I think we're on a roll, guys. Yeah, Chilling Rain's been rough, bro. So these past two ETBs, like these last two that you're seeing on screen right now getting opened up, they are more or less, oh, wow, three. That's pretty impressive. There's another code card for you. They came from a case that was just not it. Like, it was really bad how rough that case was to me. There's a regular rare Galarian Weezing, and there's an upside down code card. There you go. I hope I'm screwing with the bots right now. But yeah, this particular case of ETBs was not it. I got like one alternate art, which was nice. But aside from that one alternate art, not much came my way that was, like, you know, good, productive, or even worth it, honestly. So it's kind of funny because in the grand scheme of things, I really didn't do that well. And that's kind of heartbreaking because I really want, like, I was really hoping this set, with as many hits as it has, would have done a little bit better. But I mean, hey. It's one of those things. Maybe they'll adjust it for the future. Maybe they won't. Who knows? There's another green code card. I really hope this ETB wasn't one of those ETBs that literally just kind of gets screwy. There are packs just in the corner, just in case. If there are any auditors in the audience, here we go. Let's open up another pack. I literally nearly knocked over the entire table with that little motion. Okay, Galarian Slowking for like the 19th time. Okay, here's another code card for you. I hope I'm breaking a bot. Hello. Okay, so bad news is I have Galarian Slowking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, last pack of the first ETB. It is the Shadow Riding Pokemon himself, herself, itself. There's another code card. And, okay, Zangoose. So long story short, I really expected there to be a lot more hits in this set. There are not, and that is unfortunate. I hope they change that, because otherwise the set is really going to quickly fade into oblivion. There's a green code card for everyone. Everyone manage those expectations. We had a Malamar, which, by the way, is a beast mode Pokemon in Pokemon Showdown and the VGC meta, just in case anybody's curious. Next up on the list is a green code card and a Cybold and Golurk. Fun fact, I haven't pulled a full art Karen yet. We all know how I feel about full art Karen. She's not a Karen, dare I say. She is Karen. All right, bad news is I think I spoiled this pack for myself. Hey, I'm feeling generous. I'll give out a code card. There you go, there you go, there you go. Break a bot. Wonderful. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, just in case this is something good. And let's roll. Got a grass energy, path to the park, lady, and welcoming lantern, the Weedle doing sit-ups like I should be right now, cast form, quillfish, Ralts, Heracross, and lovely, Galarian Articuno. Fun fact, I was one of the lucky individuals to buy Pokemon Center ETBs. These are not Pokemon Center ETBs, by the way. But what's interesting is that I was told I will be receiving several of these. So if I'm not mistaken, you get one per ETB, and I ordered I ordered 20, so I think I'm going to be getting 20 Galarian Articuno Vs. If I'm not, I'm definitely calling them up and being like, what the heck, man? That was a deceptive email. Got a green code card. Got a Grookey. The good news is I don't think I have a Galarian Articuno yet, so I think that technically counts for a hit. Definitely didn't need to spend $40 to get that, though. Could have gone on TCG Player and probably won that for about 13 cents if I was feeling frisky. Got an Aggron. I'm really not enjoying this right now. Chilling rain. It's so weird. The booster boxes are so all over the place. And many of you all noted that in the video that I created as well, because obviously, sigh, that's like my eighth Calyrex. Because obviously it was one of those situations where it's like, there was one booster box that I opened up where I literally got two alternate arts in it. And then there are other ones where you don't even get four V cards. And so it's just really all over the place. Fun fact, this pack feels heavy. Not that I think packs are heavy in this set or whatever. It's probably gonna have a green code card. All right, everyone manage expectations. There you go. Galarian Sirfetch'd. Rock on. Well, I'm happy because I now have all that bulk to sort. Fun fact, in case anyone's curious about how depraved I am and how pressed I was to get my hands on this set, here are all of the code cards to like a third of the packs that I opened up. So, there is that. Now, here's what I'm gonna do. If anyone is a fan, here's like that many code cards, IDK bro. As promised, I did want to give something away, so I think I'm going to do something for our friends in the online scene right now. There is a bunch of code cards, right? Here is a security seal. If you are a fan of the channel and subscribed and leave the code word code card down below in a sentence, you will receive, I don't even know how many of those are, Chilling Rain packs. Your code is 596. So yeah, all you have to do to win this is be subscribed to the channel, like the video, and leave the word code card down below in a sentence, and you'll receive this. So another random giveaway, because your boy is not going to be doing all of that. And because I know some evil bot probably already scanned it, here is the code card. Maybe you can beat the bot. I don't know. But other than that, friends, thanks again for checking out a hot mess of a video. Chilling rain's all over the place. I'm really not a fan. I'm only excited because I'm getting more booster boxes and things of that nature from second and third prints, which I hope will alleviate some of the really bad pull rates that I've seen. And I just hope things stabilize. Like with the amount of alternate arts in this set, we should practically be getting an alternate art every single booster box. And I know that technically makes them less rare and less spicy and less interesting, but there's also a point where packs just need to be fun to open. And this is beginning to remind me a lot of Machampion's Path, and not in a good way. But with all that said, friends, thanks again for checking out another video. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, feel free to leave a like down below and subscribe to the Gengar Gang if you're not already. Friendly reminder that if you want to win this stack of code cards, all you need to do is go ahead and be subscribed, as well as like the video and leave the word code card down below in a sentence. Other than that, one other thing I wanted to say, sorry it took so long, sorting bulk is not fun, but I promise I will try to be a lot more timely with giveaways in the future. Thanks for your patience as always, friends, and we will talk soon. Peace.